Okay, everyone, so for week two, we're going to continue what we started on day two of week one, which is more work with Cordova. So we won't do it every single time, but what I had said a little while ago, and you still have some time to do it, is we've got the template that we set up last week, the one where we added all 20 plugins and put in our developer name and all of that stuff. That's already a Taco project ready to go. So I made a copy. I simply did copy and paste and put today's date. That's all I've done so far. That's what I hope you've already done since I mentioned it a moment ago. So I've got a brand new project as a little template to work with. We're still kind of exploring. We're playing with Cordova. Yes, then we will incorporate last month's project into a real final Cordova project that I want to work with, but for the moment we're still going to explore what Cordova can let us do. One of the coolest things is, of course, like the camera. We're going to look at how do we program this thing to take a photo. We're going to see that. So you should have some project. If you have your template, again, I wouldn't change my template. It's the template. So I've got a copy of the template there. If I open up my template of today's template, one thing that I want to change is the config.xml file, because it has the same, all of the same information as my previous app. And that previous app that I've been working on has been installed to my device, and it's called template, and it's saved on my device. But I often see that a conflict happens when you work on your project here at in the class, and then you work on the same project at home. There's a little bit of a difference in that the computer you worked on, I guess, puts a signature onto the device, and then you're trying to install the app at home, and it says, well, it wasn't installed from the same computer. That's a very easy fix, which is just to change this config.xml file. If you right-click config.xml, all we need to do in Notepad++, so edit with Notepad++, is the name of the widget, the name of the app, the unique ID. So I think we can put numbers in this, so I will put, let's see what happens. I forgot to check, but I'll just put today's date. Is today already the 11th? 10-11. I don't quite remember if that'll work. We'll see what happens. If that doesn't work, we'll just use words. The point is, I'm changing the package ID name because I've already got an app installed on my device called Template. It's called com.jones.template. And if I'm trying to add, if I'm trying to create a brand new project today, but it's got the same ID as the last time, there's a conflict, talk certificates or something, easy way to fix it is just change your package ID. Then that is a new app. That's all you need to do with Taco, make a copy of your template folder, give it a new ID, and it's a new app. So I'm going to save the config file. That's all I need to do there. I need to open this project, this template for today's work. I need to open it in the command prompt. I believe I have it in a handout, but the quick way to open a particular folder, instead of opening the command prompt and then navigating to the folder, remember the quick way to do it is hold shift on the keyboard and right-click on whatever Taco project you have and select open command window here. That's the fast way to open the command prompt directly in our project. So you hold shift on the keyboard, you right click, and then in there in the menu, open command window here, or command prompt. So I'm in the project, and just to confirm, because I know that I organize my folders in my own way, I like to take a quick check with Taco space platform. I just like to check, is this a fully formed and ready Taco project. So if I type Taco platform, it should check. This project has Android browser. I mean, this project has Android. For example. Browser is not required, but I like to add the browser.